Kumusta ang kitanom? That means how's growing in my wife language, Cebuano. I'm gonna tell you today integrate systems in our farm. Okay, this is a first season what we are really doing, growing more food and building more. So not so much things yet what is integrated in our farm, but one thing what is surely is our chickens. We have keeping now 1 year, almost very first we take a chickens. These ones was babies, young ones when coming last summer, and they have a mobile coop here and outdoor area. We want to keep the chicken like a free range, but it's very difficult here. We live very rural area, and you can find any kind of wild animals here. Here is a wolves, fox, wild pigs, deer, rabbits, a lynx, so many other animals who is, okay, rabbits and deer is not so much interested our chickens, but our corpse they are. But anyway, we can't keep them free, so we have to protect them like this. But not every day, but maybe every second day. Depends how much they have power to scratch the land. They have been now about 1 month outside because here is the snow, so it's not benefiting, and they don't like so much. They can handle very good native chicken, the coldness, but not enjoy the snow. So, and this area where they are now is kind of peat, and here is still, I have to remove those, but this is kind of peat, or how you call this, this is quite acid, this land. So our chicken is cleaning, eating and removing all the greens there, and then we can there is many choices what we can do. We can plant, or like this area what we, it was all the trees was here before, and we cleaning all this little area here, and we put here wood chips, and here is coming kind of little food forest, or back to Eden garden, berries and fruit trees and like that, but not high because we have a greenhouse, and the sun is here is the east, south, so we don't want to shadow the greenhouse. That way we use chickens working for us, cleaning, and we have a lot of new chicks, and when they are old enough, we bring also. And there in behind me, we have prepared it already little, but still lot of trees. This was before, but here you can see kind of first chicken run, or this is kind of silvopasture area. Actually, this is not for the chickens. This is for the ducks, and the another area is for the chickens. But anyway, same principle that the mobile tractor is driving here between the silver pasture trees and berries and everything. So it's integrate kind of plants, trees, chickens, and what I have planning, I don't know how much has time and power to make, but I put now picture here and the model of the chicken coop or the hoop system what we have. But I have planned that there is everything what they need. They have a water, they have most of the food. Of course, you have to add. And I was planning to grow also the food there beside of the that cage or net of the chicken, and they can eat, and it's giving shadow to them. So that is the one of things of them. But as I said, we have a winter here, so it's impossible to keep them outside whole year. So we have using Joel Salating model and Richard Perking model to keep the our chicken was there in greenhouse last winter, not whole winter, but most of the winter, and it's working extremely good. There was fertilizer very much, and it's now it's growing very good. We can even go to check, and we have planning same. We have now this skeleton of greenhouse, and we are building there in another north fields, and here is coming two more. So we have planning to use those greenhouses for the ducks and the chickens, that they are winter time staying there, and there is a compost, and it's warming up, and they really enjoy, they love so much. They have access to land whole year. They can scratch, and ducks we have to be building the pond where they have a free access. So this way we integrate this our farm. I have so many things, and almost daily I am thinking how I can do it more, while I'm also learning and makes things is coming little by little. Most difficult is doing in market garden. We are using interplanting, companion planting, but there is very few sources where you can learn or understand the kind of integrate the plants in a bigger area like that, where you have to grow food bigger amount, like a market garden that you have something to sell. So that is one what I still have to learn more and understand how in big field where is the market garden, that there is also kind of natural way and more than just the companion planting. We have so many different kind of crops, so it's a big challenge. But in future, I am sure that I can find good ways to do that better also. I have a video about water catchment. That is one of the things, and the compost, of course. And what I forget to say that there in where is coming our silver pasture, I have thinking after the chicken, you don't have to do necessarily nothing. It's a growing good green stuff there, grass, flowers, herbs and everything, and that is already very good food for the chicken. They can maybe even eat 20% their diet for that. But this, I don't know. But what I have thinking is that when they have cleaning the land, if I can produce my own seeds like a chicken weed or other valuable what is benefiting and what they love to eat more than just the grass, kind of putting up the diet what they can eat direct to the land. I want to seeding perennial weeds like chicken weed and maybe some herbs and the things. There is a kind of multi-purpose in my mind that after the chicken we are seeding, and when the plants is coming up, we can harvest first some, and then chicken or ducks is coming there and they harvest the rest. So we can get, they can get, and it's less our efforts for the feeding the chickens, because they can eat more and more. Especially ducks, I have planning different kind of plants for the water sources, ponds, what they have, that we can grow more in this our very short summer, that they can get the food mostly where they are living, so we don't have to feed them so much, and that kind of things. This video it will be at least 3 hours if I start to explain all where we gonna integrate in our farm, but that is one of the most exciting things and the most funniest thing for me to learn, and I try to add more and more every day, and that is my observation, that is my way to find the better solutions and the solving the problems. Yes, here is our greenhouse, and you can see how good is growing. There is a spinach, there is a Japanese salad, tatsoi, many things. Winter purslane is there. Our chilies and tomatoes is already here. But we have so cold nights that we have to use the fleece. To the plants, or otherwise they are dead. But little by little, hopefully we can soon plant all our market gardens. Here we have already garlic, beetroot. We have a companion plant. Here is the garlic and beetroot. This what is under the fleece, and here is a garlic and cucumber. Next is have to put that greenhouses, but we have so much those that we need little help for the little front loader. We have to take, and then we can finish up, and then we have more time to focus to building up this. We are a little late late already. But that kind of planning and systems we have in our farm, and in future you will see lot of different kind of same patterns and systems what we are building. Thank you for joining us in this video. Bye.